Hi, my name is Nico, and this is Christina, and we're from the University of Michigan. In this video, we'll be discussing the neurological exam of the eye and how to use its findings. As you know, there are a lot of cranial nerves involved in the eye. As a clinician, this is very useful because it'll help us determine exactly where and what is going on when there's a disease process. So the first test that I'll be discussing is pupillary constriction and dilation. We're not going to be using an actual light here, but I'm going to demonstrate it using my finger and how you would actually do the exam. So, as you know, the pupil constricts in response to bright light and dilates in its absence. So, with my imaginary bright light here, what I would do is I would hold the light to the side and then move it over onto her eye, being careful not to do too much exposure to damage the retina. And when I do that, I should see the eye with the light on it constrict, as well as the other eye. As you know, our vision developed well before LED lights, so our brain has evolved to know that when one eye is getting light, the other should be getting light as well. So I would hold the light over the one eye, and then as that constricts, make sure that the other one is constricting equally, and then move over to the bridge of her nose. Now both of those eyes will be in the shade, so they should both dilate equally. From there, I'll move on to the other eye, make sure that it's the same on both sides, make sure they both detect light equally, and I can go back and forth to make sure that's working properly. That would be testing cranial nerves 2 and 3. The next test we'll be talking about is visual fields, which is more just cranial nerve 2. So this is a test of peripheral vision. So again, I would turn toward the patient and then have them look kind of at the bridge of my nose, and we would both close one eye. We'll do that in just a second. But when you're doing this exam, it's very important that your hands be equidistant from the patient. I'm gonna be holding up different numbers, but if they're at different distances, it throws off their visual fields. So I'm gonna have you close your left eye, and I'm gonna close my right eye on the same side. And I would hold up in the opposite quadrants, one finger on one hand and two on the other, and ask her to tell me how many fingers she sees. From that, and you can, okay, your eyes open. From that, I would be able to see if she says one, then she can't see my other hand. If she says two, she can't see the top hand. And then I would switch between the fields and switch eyes to assess her peripheral vision. The third test that we'll talk about is pursuit or saccadic movements. And this is testing aside from testing your vision, it's also testing the eye movement specifically. So here, I'm gonna have you follow my finger in space. So I would draw an H and an X. So just follow, I'm gonna move it steadily and then stop. Make sure that when I'm doing this, her eyes are moving smoothly, they're following it appropriately, and that when I stop, they're not shaking. Okay, great. And so her eyes move steadily. There was no shaking. So those are all negative findings, which means that she's healthy. The last one I'll talk about is interesting because it also involves the vestibular system, which, as you know, is innervated by the vestibular cochlear nerve or cranial nerve 8. And this is involved in balance and determining your position in space. So this is called the head impulse test. And what I'm going to do is I'll place my hands on her head, and I'm going to have her focus on the bridge of my nose. So make sure, just focus on my nose, and then when I move it more suddenly, like I did toward the end, that is going to be making sure that she can still focus on my nose despite that fast movement. If she overshoots it or undershoots it, that can be indicative of vestibular disease. So that's kind of an overview of some of the eye exams that you can do with patients who have normal vision or if you suspect abnormal findings. Thank you.